I want to discuss today a couple of questions on pattern recognition. And we're going to talk about Jules Verne and his famous science fiction story about landing on the moon. So I was born in the Soviet Union, and I remember we used to often look, whenever we entered a tram or a bus, we used to look on the ticket, and there was a six-digit number. And those tickets were the first three digits added, would make the same sum as the last three digits. Somehow it was considered a lucky ticket. But people often noticed other patterns in the ticket. Certainly if you saw that the ticket says something like 111111, you'd be surprised and think, wow, that's extremely unlikely. But it's not more likely or less likely than any other number. Let's say you saw the number 5734. 0329. Is that number anyhow special? Not to you. Actually, I wouldn't have realized it either, but that number happens to be my Hebrew birthday. First full year, then month, then day. But I wouldn't know about it. At that time, I was not religious, and in fact, as most Soviet Jews, I knew very little about Judaism. I knew I was Jewish, but that's about all I knew. So I wouldn't have noticed that this ticket is very special for me. It actually says my birthday. But if the ticket would have said 1974-06-19, that I would have noticed right away. That's, of course, my birthday according to the regular calendar, according to the calendar that I was accustomed to. But nobody else would think that ticket is special. How about this? If you saw a number 321740, is that special? Well, it happens to be, for American physicists, it's very special. It happens to be the acceleration of free fall in feet per square second. But that's only in feet. 32 is approximately g in feet. But in Russia, nobody would notice it. In fact, in most of the world where they use metric system, they wouldn't have noticed it. They would have noticed, the physicist would have noticed if it was 9.8. There is no point, of course, but 9, 8, etc., all the digits according to the metric system, then they would have noticed there's something special about it, but not if it's in the system of Americans. But an American physicist most likely would notice that there's something very special about this ticket. It gives you the first six digits of G. A mathematician would certainly consider 314159 a very special ticket, because that's the digits of pi. Or 271828, that happens to be the digits of E, the base of natural logarithm. There's all kinds of numbers that are important to some people, or to people living in a particular place, or to people of certain professions. And these types of coincidences happen all the time. Considering how many different special things that happened to us, every one of us probably had situations which were the likelihood, if you wouldn't know beforehand, the likelihood of this would be one in a million. But there was something special about that situation. Again, every ticket of six digits is exactly has the likelihood of one in a million. But most of them are not special at all. And you see some random number, 254379. And it has absolutely nothing special to you. And therefore, even though it's as likely or as unlikely as any other number, but you don't consider it special. Whereas certain numbers you consider special. You say, wow, one in a million probability that I would get a ticket that shows the first six digits of pi. What about if it didn't start with 3, it showed you everything after the period? 141592, that would be the ticket. That's the digits of pi after 3 point. So those things, to a mathematician, may be some of the coincidental thing. So I wanted to tell you an interesting idea with regards to Jules Verne. He wrote, of course, about the travel to the moon. And there are some mistakes with regards to the physics of it. It's well known. I think actually even Quantum magazine itself once discussed the various errors that were made. But what's amazing is that he was able to somehow, I don't want to say to predict, but he got lucky with certain events that happened exactly the way he wrote. And that's not even, has nothing to do with physics. It's just pure luck. And that is, for example, from where did the American mission to the moon start? From Florida. And that's where Jules Verne has it. Why would that be? I mean, first of all, why would he think in the years when he wrote it that it's going to be the Americans who are going to get to the moon. But even if it's Americans, why would it be Florida? So many states. Why Florida? I mean, there are other states that are reasonably empty. In Russia, for instance, in Soviet Union, they used to send spaceships from Kazakhstan, the area that is relatively empty. Florida is not an empty area. I would have thought Nevada would have been a much better place. Some desert area would be much better. But for some reason, it was from Florida. And where did these people land? They landed in the ocean. They finished their trip in the sea. That's something that's extremely unlikely to predict, but that's exactly what Jules Verne has it. And that's how it happened. How many people were on the mission? 3. Again, a big surprise. I mean, it could have been 5, it could have been 2. Of course, the first Russian astronaut was one person, Gagarin. There's no reason to assume that it would be 3 people. And there are a bunch of other similar coincidences. Even the name is kind of similar, but that may be actually the American specifically named, knowing that the description of the first trip to the moon in science fiction has that name. That is, they named it Columbiad, and he named it, Jules Verne named it Columbiad, and the American mission was called Columbia. But that, like I said, maybe Americans specifically chose it that way. But I don't think they would choose Florida simply because Jules Verne has Florida. That would be extremely unlikely in my mind. And all of this shows that extremely unlikely things happen. I once read in Martin Gardner that there was a story, not a very well-known story, but written by a somewhat obscure author a while before the Titanic accident and catastrophe, I would rather say. And it happened to be that there were all kinds of details that happened exactly like Titanic. The big ship that was doing its maiden voyage across Atlantic was called Titan in that story, and it of course sinks on its maiden trip. And there are a bunch of other things that fit exactly. So these people weren't prophets, and they definitely didn't mean to predict what will actually happen. I don't think, by the way, the books of science fiction or adventure books even set a goal to predict what the future will be. But whatever the case may be, they did get lucky. And what does it tell you? That sometimes unusual things do happen. Please click like if you like this.